everyone, it's me, the Otaku Fango, here to review episode 4 of Darling in the FRANXX, whatever the heck you want to call this anime. So, with this episode, well, this one was quite action-packed towards the end, which was really fun to watch, but with the beginning of the episode, well, just a bunch of talking, and it's kind of boring, and I'm like, okay, I get why we're doing this, but come on. So, yeah, with Mitsuru, though, he's kind of freaking out after everything that happened to him. He's like, don't ride with her, don't do it, man. And he's just like, no, I'm gonna do that. I only have 2 more times to ride with her, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Hiro is just like, I'm all in for this, I don't care what you say, man, but, yeah, Mitsuru, he's got some injuries to heal up, but, meanwhile, with everybody else, they're talking about how, you know, basically 02 is kind of a problem, but they gotta accept it and move on. So, though with 02, she's having a little problems of her own, is that, they want to send her back to the front lines and have her not pair up with Hiro anymore because that's a problem. And, you know, how she could, you know, destroy all them if they pair up with her. So, yeah. That's not what happens at all. It's because it all comes down to, oh, there's more of the Clouser thingies. And so, you know, the group, the normal group, goes out to fight them when they come. Before a certain scene happens between 02 and Hiro, where he's in the bath and she's there and... yeah, she was like, are you think I'm a monster too? And it's like, no, I don't, please don't hurt me. Like, that's what would be me up, please don't hurt me. But anyway, so when they all go out to fight the thing, you know, they're not doing well, and of course Hiro and 02 are trying to persuade them in a way, you know, just standing there like, hey, you know, you should send us out. And they're like, no, we're not doing that because we're sending 02 back to the front lines. And she tells Hiro goodbye in a very cinematic way, you know, when they scrunch the screen down, there's like, yeah, that thing. I like that cinematic stuff they put into this anime. It's really cool looking when they do it, but, of course, Hiro is not gonna let her leave that easily because he's the protagonist. So yeah, basically he gets his resolve and he's like, you know what, no, I need to tell 02 that I want to ride with her again and everything. And so that's exactly what he does. He chases after her and she's like, huh, well, after that, I can't leave. So, you know, she escapes from the people trying to take her away, goes to Hiro, and is like, now, would you say that again, please, you know, and he's like, I want to ride with you, or whatever, and I'm just like, oh, the innuendos. There's a big innuendo later, too, when they actually get in the, Strelitzia, or whatever the heck the robot's called, the mech. I was like, wow, that's a big innuendo, but, anyway, so once they, you know, get inside of it and everything, we actually get to see, you know, her, you know, because we've never seen her, like, you know, with him in the thing, like with Mitsuru when he was with 02 in the thing, we never saw her leaning over the thing, you know, having the butt controls and everything. So that was interesting to finally actually see that, because I'm like, does she do something special when she's in there? No? Okay, good. Though we haven't seen her go crazy yet, according to Mitsuru, you know, and everything, so, because, you know, he was like, you know, she tried to devour me, mind, body, and soul, and flesh, and all that stuff, and I'm like, yeah, okay. But anyway, when they do get in the Strelitzia, they get in there, and he says the biggest innuendo I've seen so far in this anime is that I'm going deeper inside you, and I'm like, wow. Wow, dude, wow, okay, just, I'm gonna ignore that and move on. So, the fight begins, and that's where all the fighting begins, and it's a great fight, I enjoyed it. And it was very interesting how the, Clouser was, like, all one, so they all had to hold it down, and then, you know, find the core, yada yada. And I'm like, okay, cool. So, yeah, now they've learned that Hiro is, very compatible with Strelitzia, so now that they know that, I guess they're gonna let him pilot it now with 02, and they're not gonna send her back to the front lines. But with the end of the episode, the place where they, like, live or have the robots, I don't know, it started moving, and I'm like, wait, that thing moves? Why and how? What's the point of it moving? I don't really know, but it moved! So yeah, this episode was pretty interesting overall, and, we'll have to see what happens next. So, what'd you guys think of this episode? What do you think's gonna happen next? And I'll see you guys in whatever I review next. Bye!